Hey, what's going on, everyone? This is Jesus from Hustling Labs, and today I would like to show you how you can restrict content based on the user role within the page. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to come here, we're going to create option sets, an option set, and it's going to be user roles, and one would be admin, let's say business owner and user. Now we're going to come here on the user and we're going to create role. And this by default will be user. Now we're going to come here and we're going to add this is the admin page. We're going to start it a little bit just because we can. All right. Now we're going to come here to the workflow. And when this page is loaded, it's going to redirect to the index page, but only when current user role is not admin. So basically anybody that doesn't have the admin role is going to get redirected, and we're going to load the page. And there you go. Now, if I go here and change the role of this user, where is it? To admin. We're going to run it and it stays there. Now, with that being said, if I switch the role to business owner, we're going to redirect. It's going to redirect us. Now, just to make sure, we're going to go back to admin. And it stays there. The biggest thing with this is that you need to make sure that when you are creating the user, they get assigned the correct role. Or you can do it from the back end. It's up to you. But keep in mind that if the user doesn't have the right role, then they won't have access to pages that might be essential for them to be able to do whatever it is they need to do within your app. And that's it for today. This is a simple trick, an easy one that you can implement in any page. It'll take a few minutes. Again, current user's role is not admin. Here, you get created in the option sets, the user roles, and you can add as many as you want. Then here, you get nested, and it's only one user role. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.